be. It's incomplete, but it's all he has.
You've been up to something, haven't you? Too bad it's not gonna do any good. I'm a better you than you ever will be, and I've got all the time in the world. Everything you've got's going to be mine. Your life. Your wife! What are you gonna do about it? The sun's never coming up now. I could keep this up forever.
Show yourself! Whatever you say, buddy!
The rush of darkness is unstoppable. Time itself twists and tears, sweeping the champion of light back with its dark currents. Again, he enters the world, but now he sees the trap for what it is, a maze that loops back into itself.
I'm here again. He sent me back.
In Bright Falls, I was constantly under attack by birds that were more shadow than flesh and feathers. But this is an evolution. Some of the Taken were actually capable of turning into a flock of birds to escape my attacks and turning back into human form to make surprise attacks. I'm trapped in the darkness. He has started appearing to me. He can travel back into the world effortlessly, and he loves to rub my face in it. At first, he was just an echo in the darkness, a flicker beyond the edge of my vision. Now he started showing himself, getting bolder all the time, telling me what a great time he's having in the world while I'm stuck here, and what he plans to do, especially to Alice. All the moves I have left are dangerous and desperate. I have no choice. I have to hunt him. With all the herbs, crystals, and the rest of her New Age paraphernalia, Emma Sloan had been called a hippie and a freak and worse. It was that small town mentality. She was a female mechanic, and even in 2011, there were always going to be backward shit kickers who thought that was a hoot. She didn't mind. She could deal. She could take any engine apart, even the new ones with all the computers in them. Turned out that these boys were awful polite while waiting for her to put them back together.
Okay, people, it's Eddie Rodman here with a few hours to kill, and there's nobody I'd rather spend them with. Nobody else in the whole world. Oh, boy, that'll land me in hot water when I get back home, won't it? Well, just in case my wife is listening, and you always are, aren't you, baby? Let me tell you, you are the exception, honey, and the prettiest lady I ever saw at a boot. But I'd really like to spend some quality time with you listeners, because, you know, tonight's one of those nights. You're sitting in the studio and you kind of forget how long it's been or what day it is. You just sit here and go through the motions. You might as well have been here forever. You keep talking, but you don't even know what you're saying. It's like you're on automatic. You can't stop the ride and get off. It's times like these that I really wish that somebody would just call in and relieve my boredom. How about it? Anybody? Come on now, help a fella out. Our lines are open.
Emma? You here?
Wow, it is you. I guess all of it really happened.
You remember me?
Kind of. I felt weird all day, like I could almost remember a dream I had. And then, just before sunset, I remembered the page.
Yeah. I'm going to have to go get those things again.
Not all of them. I went out and got them. Well, most of them. I felt stupid at first, but then it was getting dark, and those things started showing up, and one of them made off with the battery. It ran into the railroad tunnel. There was no way I was gonna follow him in there. Sorry.
It's good you didn't. You should be careful. I mean, really careful.
Yeah, I kinda remember something. Something bad happened to me, didn't it?
Forget it. It doesn't have to happen again, okay? Just do what I say.
Yeah, okay. God, this is too weird. Am I going crazy here? Just go get that battery.
Try to stay calm. You're perfectly sane. We're caught in a time loop. That's why this is happening again.
I believe you. God, I feel like I might just lose it any second now. How come you're not freaking out over this?
Because on my personal weird shit-o-meter, this just doesn't right.
Look, I know something happened to me before...
You're gonna be okay, if you just keep cool, okay? Thanks for getting this stuff for me, it's a big help.
I hope so. Are you gonna make everything blow up at the oil field again?
I have to.
Well, whatever the hell else you might be, at least you're not boring.
Just the battery. That'll save time.
Night Springs doesn't exist. It's a fictional town from the TV show I used to work on. It was Any Place USA, a place we used as a backdrop for whatever strange story we had that week. One of the stories I wrote for the show involved a man, the champion of light, fighting his evil double, the herald of darkness. It was something I'd written back in the real world, something I had a link to, a framework I could build on. I had adapted it into a new story. This story.
Okay. So this chick just came up to me and said she's my biggest fan. I know. They all say that, right? And she's giving me the eye. So I make a couple of moves. We have a couple of drinks. And then things start happening. But I say I have to go to the bathroom first. Uh-oh, right? She's got no idea. Watch this. This is gonna be priceless.
That's nice.
I thought you'd like that. Are you tense? You feel a little tense.
Maybe a little. I had a crabby day.
Yeah?
Don't worry. It's improving real fast.
Yeah.
Hey, don't stop. It's just getting good.
Watch this.
Now Night Springs is in Arizona, although not for long. It's in Arizona because whatever the town that has become Night Springs is really called is located near one of the thin, worn places in the world where dreams and reality flow together and life is always a little strange. Perfect analogy for Night Springs. I can't return to the real world. I've tried, but I'm operating on dream logic, forcing the door open a crack so I can slip through. I can enter the strange little town of Night Springs. All I did was put in Arizona for one night.
Thank you.
Well, this should be perfectly safe. Now I just need her to charge this up.
Thank you.
Found the battery.
Okay, I'll charge it. Here. Try not to get killed.
Okay. I'm gonna take care of this. Try to stay calm.
Look, what if I just... What if you stay here with me, please?
I'm sorry, but if I don't deal with this, no one else will.
Yeah, I guess. It's just that this is getting really creepy. I believe this is real, but I don't understand any of it. I'm getting scared. I can't believe you're so calm.
I get scared, but I've had a lot of time to get used to it. That helps. The guy who looks like me is the reason this is happening. I caught up with him, but he swept me back here.
Back in time?
Yeah, it's a trap. We'll be doing this forever unless I can break out of it.
How are you gonna do that?
I'm working on it. I came prepared, but things got kind of scrambled when I arrived. I'm tracking down the things I need.
Yeah, well, feel free to climb back into your DeLorean or whatever it is you do.
Go again. Better get ready to run.
Thank you. be in trouble. Better hurry.
Okay, it's safe now.
About all of this?
I'm gonna need those keys to the diner now. There's a motel key there that I have to get.
Oh, hey, you don't have to do that. I have the motel master key. I work for the same company, you know. What's at the motel?
Well, there's a dead guy. He's got something I need to get into the Mount Redtooth Observatory.
God, that's awful. Hey, you wanted to know about the guy who looked like you, didn't you?
The last time you said he had a party, but you didn't go.
No, that's not true. I did go. It was really great at first, and then I didn't see it myself, but I hear he turned nasty. He hurt a bunch of guys pretty bad, and there was this girl, she died. But I didn't hear about that until afterwards. I thought that he was so charming.
And then he went to the diner.
That's right. I wasn't involved with that at all. I don't know what happened.
Fine. I need to check out these motel rooms. In the meantime, you stay here, okay? I'm serious. Keep the lights on and stay here.
Yeah, okay. You got it. I sure hope you're right about this.
You're gonna stay here this time, right?
Because the last time I didn't and that thing, whatever it is, happened to me.
Yeah. I don't want you to get hurt again.
Don't worry, I'm gonna stay put. I don't remember what happened exactly, but I learned my lesson.
Good. It doesn't have to happen exactly the same way this time around. You proved that much when you went out and got those things for me. I think you're gonna be okay.
Let's hope you're right.
Thank you.
Alice and Barry, my wife and my best friend, are easily the two most important people in my life, and they've never really gotten along with each other. I suppose both of them resent the other's intrusions into what they considered their domain. After I was gone, they maintained an uneasy truce. My book stayed in print, still selling, the licensing machine churned away. She was my wife and controlled the intellectual property. He was my agent and took care of the business. I wish they found more common ground than that.
It's said that nobody knows what the future might bring, but for this man, it's no longer entirely true. A weaker man might simply give up, but the champion of light is an expert on destiny. Sometimes the puppet and puppeteer can be one and the same. Mount Redtooth, its top littered with man-made eyes that stare into the endless depths of space. Tonight, the Champion of Light will depend on them to pick out a message from the ether. As history repeats itself, the man remembers the patterns. He knows that he needs the missing part for the telescope.
Praise be. You guys are coming through for me. A pretty little light just started blinking on my board here, and that means there's a caller out there. You know, when the hours stretch into eternity like this, when it feels like I'm stuck in a rut and just reliving the same endless night over and over again, I feel genuinely touched by someone actually reaching out to me, breaking the monotony. I just want you to know that it really matters to me. Caller, you're on the air.
You suck, Eddie!
Did you know that this is my dream job? True fact?
When Dr. Rachel Meadows got the call from Michael, telling her to hurry to the observatory, she didn't waste any time. It had been a nice party. She'd had a good time, but her social life would always play second fiddle to the mysteries of space. Michael never showed up, of course. He pulled over at the wrong rest stop. She never even thought about him at the time. The phenomenon in the sky above her was too fascinating.